Hello everyone, in this video we are going to learn another topic of advanced data structure called hash table. This is our learning maps. We are now at the lesson 5. We are talking about hash table data structure. And this is the content of this lecture. Firstly, we will talk about the time complexity, followed by the introduction to hashing and some other key function and key terms in order to work with hash table. And later on we will see on what we call is collisions, the kind of problem that we can see in the hash functions. The data will be duplicates, so we have some collision resolution techniques, and we will see it together in the following slides as well as the examples. Okay, let's start from the time complexity. Time complexity is normally a time which is required for an algorithm to run, as we can know that every time that we run the program, the time execution is really depending on how we define our codes, how the way we operate the process control flow of the program, how many loops do we have, or how many type of data structure that we use. These make the time execution less or more depending on your logic. And for the time complexity here, it is normally denoted by big O notation. We have O here, and then we have some variable inside, example O of n mean that it takes n times. Sometimes it is O of a constant number of 1, which is the time is really less taken execution. Normally the time taken here we are considering on three types of scenario: base case, average case, and worst case. In the worst case, it means that our program run take very much time, it's very time consuming. And we have normal average case, there's some certain scenario that it makes our program run very stable. And for example, on the data structure like linked list array, we have consider on the time complexity when you use the search operation. In linked list, the time complexity, for example, if we have n number in the list, so the time complexity t is O of n notation of n, because we don't know which will be find the that number in the list depending on how many times that we loop through the list in the element. And we have the array, and actually there are two types, the sorted and unsorted. So in case of unsorted array, the time complexity is normally taken as O of n, while array with sorted numbers inside, we have logarithm base 2 of n. This is the time complexity taken for each data structure. And for more detail about big O notation, I recommend that you can watch another video talking more detail about big O notation. You can access with the short link bit.ly/312x9ou, which will link you to the YouTube video. And it will take you only 5 minutes. And next, talking about the searching operation, the way we want to search data inside our data structure. Sometimes we need to loop, for example, in array, you need to loop from the first position to the last position. Sometimes if the number that we are looking at, we are trying to search, it is in the middle, okay, it take like time the average case, right? And sometimes that number that you want to find, it is in the first element, so it's very fast, right? It's considered a base case. And the worst case is that number is positioned at the last element in the array. So normally for this data structure, linked list, array, stack, and queue, the time required to search is the O notation of n, which we don't know exactly, like it depending on how the number is positioned is stored, right? So in the worst case is big O notation of n. We need to find n time. For example, you have 100 elements. It's possible that it may take you to loop 100 times to reach that number. However, if you're talking about the hash shape or data structure, you don't need to loop to randomly search in the data structure. You can actually use the what we call hash function to get our data directly. You don't need to loop. It's very fast, right? The big O notation in here is 1. It means that when you want to search some data inside your data structure as hash table, you can search it very fast, okay? Because it uses the key value pair. So next thing, we will talk about some terms and of the function that we will use in the hash table data structure. Hash table is a kind of data structure that is used to store key value pair, and it is implemented as array. Actually, if we look, take a bit more in detail to solve the collision duplication data technique, we'll also integrate the linked list inside the array. And behind the hash table, actually it uses the hash function in order to compute an index of an array in which an element should be inserted into. For example, you have an array, and then there is a number that you want to insert to array. Based on hash table rule, you need to calculate the index through the hash function, and next that number will be inserted into that index position calculated by the hash function. So mostly we work with hash function. We will introduce that in the later on slide. And basically here, just for your information, in hashing, normally large keys are converted into smaller ones by using the hash function. Then we store the value in the hash table. And this gives you an overview of how the hash function works. It actually kind of function that compress your data into smaller size so that you can fit into your array. Here is an example of a popular function that work with array. Normally, we use the modulo operation when we have some data to insert. We basically find the remainder. For example, if the size of array is 7, you can find operation modulo with 7 in order there to insert the net number into certain position. For example, you have an array of size 7 and you want to insert number 3. So normally number 3 we don't insert directly into the first element. It really depending on your hash function. So in this case, you take that number, let's say you put 5, right? So 5 modulo of 7, you got how many? It's 5, right? Okay. So that means that number 5 will be inserted into the position number 5. However, if you want to input number 10, okay, so you can take number 10 modulo by 7, we got the remainder is 3, right? So number 10 will be inserted to the position 3 in the array. That's how it works. Okay, next, without any further delay, I think we better look into the implementations for better understanding. So this is a basic hashable implementation. You can create some array. Actually, it's an array, and then we need to define how our element could be installed into that array. It does not install from position 0, 1, to 3. It really depending on the hash function that we define. So in here, as you can see, that we create an array with size 7. I create a size as a constant so that we can use in our other functions. So it's just the way you create a function, constant. Just put a const. It comes from constant. It's a keyword, right? So that you can create an array with this size, and then you can use this constant with other function. Okay? It's easy, right? If you want to increase the size of the array, we just update the constant number here. Okay? So we have the hash function. Okay, basically we can use the modulo operation with the size of the array, so because the size is 7. So this function will return. Actually, it is index of the element that should be inserted into this hash table. And we can create another function called insert our data into the hash table. Let's say the name is insert data, and then we have some value that we want to insert to. And actually, this function is really straightforward, that we call to the hash function, which in term of the return value, it is an index. And next, we can actually access to the array through this index, and then we assign this value into it. It's very basic. And last but not least, we can display our hash table using a function where we can use another for loop, because that it is a kind of array, right? So we can access to our element inside the array using the for loop. The normal way that we access to array is very basic part of the hash table. So this is how we implement it, and then we can actually insert some data for testing and then display our hash table. So to be better on to understand on this, we will take a look at deeper implementation in coding. Just now I would like to explain to you a little bit more. In case the NV inputs number 7 here, because that we know that our array is a size of 7, right? So let's say we have a box here. Let's say a box, we have 7 slots, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, right? So we insert number 7, as we can know that the position of the array, it is start from 0, right? So 0 here until the last one is 6, right? 6. So when we want to insert number 7, based on our hash function, we will insert it using this hash table function, right? It will find the position, the index that this number should be inserted into, because we have passed the index into this array syntax. So in case of number 7, the modulo is should be 0, right? So it means that number will be placed in the first position, which is 0 here, right? And next, we put number 8. So 8, if we divide with 7, the size of the array, we will get the remainder is 1, right? So it means that number 8 will be put into the position number 1 in the array. So in here, it just seems like you insert our data like our traditional way, first element, second, right? But let's see with another point, that we want to insert our data 25. Okay. So 25, if we divide by 7, we will get the remainder, which is 4, right? Then 4, we will try to look over it, which is the position is 4. So 1 here, 2, 3, 4 here, right? So it means that number 25 will be inserted into this place, because based on hash function, the position is obtained at number 4, right? Because we put the operation modulo inside here. That's how it works. So in this, the end where you display our number inside the array, you will get this number. So the other position, normally it is 0. So as you can see here, at the first position 0 here, you got number 7, and position number 1 you got number 8, otherwise like 2, 3, 5 and 6 it is empty slot, right? So in order to display, we can actually display our like certain static number. For example, in here you can put some any number to initialize your array, just in case here we display, if you put 0 we get 0. But if you don't put it, we'll get the full value of the array if we don't assign any data into the element slots of the array. So as you can see, this is how it works. However, we will see another point which we call collision. For example, if you want to insert some data like here, you have 7, 8, 15, 22, and 25. So there are some collision in here. As you can see in this output, the number 15 is overridden, right? Because when we insert number 22, if we do an operation divide by 7, 15 divided by 7, we got remainder 1. But when we insert number 22 here, when we divide by 7, based on hash function, the remainder is also 1. So it means that number 22 here will go into the place where we insert 15, right? The same, so it is overlap. I mean, data override number 15 is gone now, because another number is inserted into this position. Okay? This is a kind of problem that we call it as a collision. However, we have a solution to solve it. We will see it later in the following slide.